Hello, viewers. Tonight, I'm going to read Chapter 6 of Claymore. Clang? What is it? I heard something. You're imagining things. We just patrolled this area, and we didn't see a single soul. That's true. The entrance to the cathedral is more heavily guarded than usual. No Yoma could possibly get in. Huh? That's impossible. We checked the cathedral from top to bottom. Other than a few soldiers, the only ones here should have been the priests. How's it? It can't be. You... Sleeping noises. So sorry. It's bright. Time to wake. Oh no, Claire's... Okay, I don't know what type of sound effects these are, and I'm, you know, gabot? No. I'm not even gonna try to say that. Okay. I mean, there was a time when I tried to sound... Okay, I just do sound effects that I can really sort of, understand. I cannot understand gabot. I don't know how I would say that. Which is... I mean, some sound effects I just cannot understand in comic books. I really cannot. Or manga, so to speak. Okay. So you're awake. Claire, your eyes have changed back. Oh yes, the pills only work for half a day. When the effects wear off, I have to take more. So I'll always carry some with me. My powers only just came back, but I already sense something. It's moving inside the cathedral. Don't move. We're looking for Yoma. The half-eaten bodies of two soldiers were found yesterday in the cathedral. Come with us. Claire. Yeah, she was about that height. Looked pretty suspect running around the rooftops last night. Didn't you two arrive in town yesterday? Sid, gawk. Weren't you supposed to be on guard duty at the cathedral last night? Take it easy. I'm not saying I think the girl from last night was a Yoma. It's not like the thing suddenly showed up yesterday, or today. But for someone to catch my knives in mid-air, with their bare hands... I doubt an ordinary girl could do that. But maybe someone who isn't allowed here. Say a silver-eyed half-monster of a witch. I bet she could. Good. The pills worked in time. Your eyes don't look silver. You're a pretty one, aren't you? But we fought a half-breed who dirtied her body with monster flesh. It wouldn't be surprising if she could change the color of her eyes. Now would it? Shump! Ow! What are you doing, you little runt? Who are you calling a little runt, you pumpkinhead? What? Who do you think you are, talking to my sister like that? She's the kindest, most gentle person I know. Stop talking to her like you know her, because you don't. You little runt! Okay. He gets grabbed. Gawk! Let's go. We're done here. I forgot to say, but... And yeah, he has to walk away. Okay. What a jerk. He only got here the day before yesterday. What? Oh, no. Okay, he was speaking. Okay, he says, what a jerk. Okay, this is him speaking, I guess. Yes, it is him speaking. I have to really be careful that I don't, mess up. What? No, it's just... You came out with that nonsense so quickly. Huh? What you said to that pumpkinhead, I mean. Oh, well, the part about you being my sister was a lie, but I meant it when I said you were kind and gentle. I really think that way. Even if that man had hit you, I doubt I would have stopped him. Oh, goodness, no. Okay, I have to... Very sorry I messed up the voices. Even if that man had hit you, I doubt I would have stopped him. Eh? The same goes if he had tried to hit me. If my life isn't in danger, and my mission isn't at risk, I wouldn't do anything. If you're looking for kindness from me, give it up. You'd be hurt and betrayed eventually. Claire, I've spoken to Father Vincent. If you like Rabona, you can stay here. Remember that. Okay. And that was sort of the whole dynamic of... And I guess it's time for a little commentary now, I suppose. Because I sort of got messed up on voice lines, I suppose I should... Say a few things. This is the... The whole dynamic between them is somewhat interesting because... Well, to some degree, because... If she didn't have some kindness, she wouldn't have taken him in the first place. And people may say, well, she just took him because he's around, but... She still took him and decided to... She has shown some kindness, but, I mean, that is the dynamic between of these characters. They're not exactly robotic, but apparently they're supposed to be less emotional, less social, so to speak. But to some degree, they still are social. And a commenter who comments on this channel had said that Yoma also do not need social interaction, but... In this manga, a few chapters before this chapter, we saw a few Yoma basically socialize and try to group up to basically kill her. So, a person could also say that about humans. A person could also say that people also do not need social interaction, but... I mean, because you can technically live without social interaction, but... She does socialize to a degree, but is socially awkward and is just singularly focused on her job, on her profession. So it is interesting. She is not exactly like a robotic character. Personally, I think a character such as this is somewhat hard to sort of implement, to convince the reader, or even sort of get the reader invested in their development, so to speak. It's very interesting. But, and some things are going to sort of reveal some of the nuances of this relationship to a degree, and some of the, how should I say, the similarities between her childhood and you know, this boy's childhood. But, oh goodness, I'm spoiling things again. I'm so sorry. Anyhow, I should just continue. Okay. Two guards were killed last night. It happened inside the cathedral. Like the other times. Did both of them have their insides eaten? Yes. There are more victims every day. This week alone, there have been 5. Your insides, your guts, what may also be called viscera. That is something, and this is the first time we've, as far as I know, well, we knew that Yoma eat flesh, but for whatever reason, and we're gonna see more of this talk about, oh yeah, Yoma love guts, Yoma love to eat people's insides and all of this talk. This concept of eating people's insides, especially their guts, and just cannibalism, because whether they're infected with something or not, basically all of this can be considered cannibalism to some degree. Because that's basically what it appears as. And this whole manga, and the anime as well, really focuses upon it. Now, some may say it is not cannibalism, they're something entirely different, but especially later on in the manga, this concept is going to be very, very, very emphasized. Now there are some very interesting implications of eating a person's guts, and some very carnal implications. Sexual even. Some people may disagree, but some people may understand what I'm saying, because they're particular, how should I say, there's a whole porn industry around gore, but anyhow, as I said, commentary is going to be weird, and I'm, most of this, of the talk that I'm going to do having to do with cannibalism and having to do with sort of the implications of sort of eating human flesh, which this whole manga has to do with, and I can spoil this. And it's not so much a spoiler as is a fact. They're not eating anyone else except humans. I mean, you have these monsters, all right, who for whatever reason just want to eat humans. They're not going around eating deer or, you know, cats or dogs or whatnot. I mean, they specifically want humans, which, you know, considering that they are called Yoma, and Yoma means evil spirit or demon in Japanese, demons are known to feed on people. So there are some religious and spiritual implications here as well, in this manga. Are they that extensive? I really can't say, but as we read, we're going to see more. And I will have more to talk about. And the commentary will most certainly become quite rich. Especially as we go to some of these combat-heavy chapters. Which this has combat in it, but not as much as some chapters. Okay. So, let's see. There are more victims every day. This week alone, there have been 5. Okay. It seems to have a voracious appetite. Let me see. This is her talking, I suppose. I think that's her talking. Okay. Voracious appetite. Usually, Yoma don't eat that much. It's enough for them to eat the guts of a human once every week or two. But the longer a monster lives, the more its appetite grows. They get more cunning and stronger. We call them voracious eaters. Now, and something just came to my mind. Because the idea is these Yoma, alright? They eat humans. They are basically cannibals. Alright, and that is what I will call them, because in the later part of the manga, that statement is sort of justified to some extent, Now, whether you say hey, they have a parasite or Yoma is some type of being that's living within them, and still what we see is cannibalism. We see a humanoid figure eating other humans. What we see in the manga is cannibalism, whether they call it something else or not. And the reason I emphasize that term so much is because, well, I have read other manga that have very similar contexts, and one that even had more sort of more human sort of the eating of humans, more flesh eating than this, which is quite a surprising thing to say. I mean, one in which they show a manga, which I may or may not read on this channel, in which there's just whole pages of people eating guts, okay, which is quite, I mean, that has some very, very stunning implications, to be entirely honest. And I'm already collecting quotations from different books about the significance of cannibalism and what it means and what type of psychological and symbolic purposes it has, as well as ritualistic purposes, to some degree. But anyhow, something came to my mind, and I thought, you know, Yoma, they only eat humans. What else only eats humans? What else only feeds on humans? Vampires. So Yoma in a sense are somewhat like vampires. Now, as I said, Yoma basically means demon in Japanese. I think Yoki means ghost power. So there are spiritual concepts involved here in language. Now, in terms of people sort of talking about the biological side of it, I can't really talk about that. There's a person who often comments on the channel who is named Red Moon Blood Moon. He knows more or less a lot about biology and natural sciences, that type of branch. He knows quite a lot about it. Myself, I am more concerned with words, symbols, and narratives. Personally, I don't think that many of the biological sort of horror aspects, which are like Parasite Eve, were so very thought out in this particular manga. Now, in Parasite Eve, there's a lot of explanation to everything. Now, if some of you don't know what I'm talking about, it was no PS1 game that sort of had a similar idea to this series, to an extent. But personally, from what I have basically read, Yoma, like vampires, they only feed on humans. They only feed on people. Which is very strange, because they're supposed to be these voracious eaters. They're supposed to, I mean, voracious eater or what have you, and all the other types of monsters that we're going to read about, they have one thing in common. They're all humans. They're not going to eat a deer or a cow or anything else. They only want humans. And are we going to have an explanation about that in this manga? Personally, maybe as I'm reading it, because I've already read it once before, maybe there was something that I overlooked, and maybe we will find something that tells us why Yoma and their counterparts only eat humans. But they seem very much like vampires, to be entirely honest, because when you think about it, vampires only eat humans. They only feed on humans. Now, they don't eat guts, but they drink blood. But in this case, it is different. But nonetheless, it's not that much different, because, you know, the prey is humanity. Very interesting, to be honest, because I never thought about that. I never thought, well, Yoma seem like vampires. All of these creatures in this manga that basically feed on people, they're a lot like vampires, except they're just ripping people apart and just tearing them open, and it's pretty disgusting. But that does make sense now, because The questions often come to mind, and that is another reason why I call it cannibalism, because if it was just them eating flesh and they just wanted flesh, it would make sense if they would just eat any animal. They would just go in the forest. You would see these Yoma in the forest and just eating anything they can find. As I read this, I will peradventure see if I can find some type of further context for that, to be honest. I don't know if I will, because I'd read this before, and who knows. But anyhow, I will say no more about that, because I think it's sort of, in a sense, it's sort of a spoiler. Not to say I haven't given you many spoilers already. Alright. Now, right here. But the longer a monster lives, the more its appetite grows. They get more cunning and stronger. We call them voracious eaters. I'm afraid one of them is hiding in the cathedral. It knows that my kind can't come here, and that we are the only ones who can see them. Will we be all right against a creature like that? I need facts, the names of everyone who came and went from the cathedral last month. No one could come or go. After killing started, the cathedral has... And I did read this with a different voice because I thought the boy was speaking. I don't know. But, I mean, it's very hard for me to keep track. But I do believe the priest is speaking now. After the killing started, the cathedral has been completely sealed off at night. Only the priests and monks were here, and a few soldiers chosen for guard duty. Those two guards from yesterday showed how hard it is to sneak in and out unnoticed. I have to assume it's somebody on the inside. Okay. In that case, I'd like to know who was here last night. Of course. Bishop Kamori was in the sanctuary. He has been with the cathedral the longest and holds the highest rank. Father Rodo is usually at his side. He, too, has been in Rabona for a long time and is an aide to Bishop Kamori. Also in the sanctuary were the monks Paizan and Rudo. The others were Father Serene, Father Arugo, and Father Pario, and the monks Kaisaro and Teniso. That's 10 people altogether. The soldiers are rotated regularly. Most stand watch at the cathedral entrance. Captain Ganesu is there often. Good. Be careful around those people. But... You're not saying it's one of them. They're all people I trust. Abandon your notions. A yeoman in disguise can fool even family members. I still don't understand why it stays inside the cathedral. Once it sneaked into the holy city, it could roam outside the cathedral. Why would it limit itself to such a confined area? How can it be so confident that it won't be found out? That's the question. I feel like I've forgotten something vital. Okay. Dashing. Something moved. Must be that girl. Let's go. She's headed for the cathedral. Okay. Padam. Okay. I'm not going to do the sound effects. I'm terrible at the sound effects. Zat. Okay. It's hard for me not to do the sound effects when I see them on the screen, so I don't know. Oh, goodness. Okay. I tripped up. Let me start over again. Leaping across rooftops isn't as fast as running on the ground. Oh, goodness. I mean, That sword sound. No. This is what I get for doing the sound effects. I'm very sorry, people. Okay. Alright? No more excuses. Kind and gentle sister. This time you flashed your silver eyes. Even your face looks different from this afternoon. Sorry, but I don't have time. I won't hold back if you get in my way. If you're going to come at me, go ahead. So you've shown your true colors. You have the aura of a monster witch, even though you're only a half-breed. Sorry, but the law here says that anything unholy must be eliminated. Now. Whoa. Okay, I have to do some of the sound effects. I have to try, because reading fight scenes, or at least narrating fight scenes in manga. Oh my goodness, the sound effects. It's... Okay, let me see. I don't know if he's throwing knives, or... What is that? Or is she... I don't know. Yaw! Clang! Okay. She blocked that sword. Click. Whatever that is. Okay. With an S. Ugh! Take this! Phew, 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 phew. Okay. Anime sounds. Phew, 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 phew. Damn! Okay, I am trying. There are some people who are really good at Oh my goodness, there's some people who are really good at sounds, especially people who do beatboxing and all of that type of stuff, who can do all types of sounds with their mouths and just, oh goodness. Okay, but you'll have to sort of settle with my my sort of weak performance and sound effects. Okay, I mean, it's a bit different with manga, because you have to sort of... I mean, comic books have always had these weird written-out sounds that you have to pronounce. If you don't pronounce them, even if you're reading it in your head, and you just say, hey, these sound effects are so weird, I don't even want to say them in my... Like, when you're reading in your head, when you're just reading it and you're not speaking out loud, you still... I don't know. I mean, you could... Who knows? But when you're narrating, it's... Okay. I'm sure that I could just not do them, but when I see it on the page, it just feels as though I have to. Whack! Damn, her swords! Can't we do something? I know. Here goes. Yurrah! Chang! Okay. Flick. Puck. Okay. Kasha. Okay. Kasha. Okay, that's terrible, but I have to do it. I mean, some of you, I don't know. For the people who are just listening to it and not looking at the images, which some people apparently do, some people listen to it. I don't know if they're looking at the images or not. Yeah. I mean, when you see it on the page, you see what types of sound effects I'm trying to pronounce, and I just have to say, this is one of the reasons why fight scenes are probably my least favorite chapters. I mean, combat-heavy chapters I've never really liked, because it's full of sound effects, and the things you have to do in your mind get in the mood, so to speak. Okay, now, zat! Flack! Huh? Did she block the knives with just her cape? Okay, so I guess he threw knives at her while he took the daggers or whatever type of knives she has in her hands. And even though he cut himself, he did it, which, you know, to be honest, I kind of like, it's just like I said, these were my two favorite characters, because, I mean, they sort of remind me of a real RPG. I mean, you have your rogue here, you have your classic knight kind of guy, so to speak. I really like these two characters, okay? I wish they did more in this manga, but unfortunately, as you can probably figure out by now, they don't really use people that much. And I mean, it's just claymores, and that's all. Hey, Berserk! Yeah, you like the two great swords in Berserk? We have great swords in Claymore. And let me just say this, because here's the commentary. There is going to be commentary in this video. Swords. Big swords. Great swords. Big phallic symbols. Big swords. I mean, there was a time, oh my goodness, especially in the late 90s, throughout, even today, Cloud Strife, Final Fantasy VII, big sword. Guts. Berserk. Big sword. Inuyasha, big ol' sword. You see less of it. You still see it now. Of course you do. But I mean, and I just put it this way. I know sometimes I complain about realism in comic books, manga, and media. But I just think, hey, can we do something instead of big swords? Can we do an axe? Can we do, I mean, even these daggers are a breath of fresh air, though even that has sort of exploded, because everyone has to have two daggers, and it's just, I mean, all this stuff came from Dungeons and Dragons, D&D days, anyway, you know, that type of culture, but Japan decided, hey, really big swords are cool, especially after Berserk. And it's just, hey, I mean, I remember Trunks in Dragon Ball Z. His sword wasn't some giant sword, but he cut Frieza up with it, okay? And that was Dragon Ball Z before Super, which, hey, most people do not like Super. I am one of those people. Not to say that I like any particular media, so to speak, but Super just did not look as good, and hey, anyhow, that is me ranting about swords. Sorry for wasting your time, people, with that. I try to sort of do more commentary at the end of videos now, but sometimes I cannot help myself. Okay. In between my commentary and these, and me trying to struggle and do these sound effects, okay. Kwonk? I mean, no, goodness. Kwonk? Oh, goodness. I mean, okay. Sure. Kwonk. I mean, and that is a kick right in his... Okay, that looks like that... Okay. I mean, way to put a man down, Claire. But hey, we... Whatever. I mean, of course, she kicks there, of all places. Okay. I mean... You would think, even if you're stupidly overpowered, can you not kick there? Can you do something else? Why do you have to kick there? Of all places! I mean, but, okay. I mean, maybe that's a commentary on something. Maybe that's, maybe there's a reason she kicked there that, I mean, goodness. I mean, he already cut his hand, now you gotta kick him in the... I mean, of course he has armor, but... I mean, she's so strong, maybe even her kick... I mean, maybe your armor doesn't really do much from a kick from her, because she's a claymore. Okay, grrr! Whatever sound effect that is. Okay. I mean, I have to do the sound effects, because there's so little reading in the fight scenes. The fight scenes are... I mean, manga fight scenes have never really been... I've never really liked comic book or manga fight scenes. Oh my goodness, one day I need to read some pop fiction on this channel. Just for the heck of it, pop fiction is not as popular. But anyhow, never mind that. You! Okay, he's dashing. Bam, bam. Stump. Okay. She's jumped up there, and they can't reach her. Okay. Phew! Okay. Oh, they're surprised. So that's a silver-eyed witch? A claymore! Oh! What was that? It was inside the cathedral. Pew pew. Damn. After her. Hey, what? It's inside. Let's go. But the law says that after dark. Forget that. Clack. And that is a strange rule. Because, okay, I suppose the guards do not know it's in the cathedral, but you are standing guard around the cathedral, and you would... I don't know. Maybe they're not that intelligent. I have no idea. That doesn't make sense to me, because... Okay. Everybody is surprised that she's just running right past them. Huh? What was... Okay. Just now. Who was that? Now this is a sound effect that... Sasat? I'm sorry that I go crazy when I see... I mean, comic books, I just put it this way. When I first started to do these narrations for manga, and I know I keep calling them comic books, a lot of people don't like that, for manga, but basically they all do the same thing, where the reading out the sound effects, they really perplex me. It perplexes me how they write these, because I have to sound these out. Even if I'm reading them by myself, and I'm not doing narration, I still have to sound them out, and I have to sort of... think about the sound in my head, and I don't know. It really sort of, I mean, could comic books and manga just have writing without the sound effects that are written out? I get the idea. You're supposed to sort of make a similar sound effect in your head, but it's, to me, it's, I just think, couldn't I just sort of under, sort of, how should I say... That shouldn't be too hard. I shouldn't need these guides. These little words. Okay. Enough of me going crazy about these sound effects. Cree. Oh, that's terrible. Because I don't know... I don't know what Cree is. Anyhow. It's here. I sense its aura. Because of the pills. Side effects. I can't tell what a Yoma is. Where is it? Another soldier, with his insides eaten. Okay, people, you're gonna have to get used to that, and a lot worse. It's just as I'd said when I did the introduction video for the series, I said, this manga, it is gonna have a lot of that, and there are going to be even more bloody things in it. For those of you who have never read this before, who have not seen the anime, yes, it is going to get very bloody and disturbing, in my opinion. Anyhow. I knew it. It's the work of a voracious eater. Oh. Wham. Crack. Oh. It's huge. For one this big to sneak in. Suck, 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 suck. Okay. Okay. No, it's knives. I mean, thuck thuck for... Oh, come on. These sound effects for knives, why can't it be... Okay, that's going to be my sound effect for these knives hitting him. Because thuck thuck is not for... Come on. Come on, writers. Why did you... never mind. I'm so very sorry. I should just improvise with these sound effects because this is not a good guide for me. Okay, I mean, for stuck. Maybe I can. Never mind. Oh, goodness. They could write it a bit different so that I could understand how to say that. Okay. What the hell? Is that a Yoma? Yeah. Stay back. You're no match for it. Thump. Swap. No, it's Cuthap. Okay. Well, because it's the Japanese type of it's comic or manga. It goes from right to left. So it's Thap Ka. Okay, I could get Cuthap, but Thap K. Never mind. Never mind, I'm very sorry. Oomph. Kashak. Growl. Whap. Slash. Okay. I'm very sorry for that spectacle that I happened to give you. Now that, that was because most of that chapter consisted of sound effects. So, maybe that isn't so very entertaining, to be entirely honest. But some chapters are simply going to be like that because the sound effects, oh my goodness. Sound effects are not my strong suit. I don't think sound effects are anyone's strong suit, to be entirely honest. I know some people narrate differently, but to tell you the truth, it's just as I said. I was surprised how few people do manga narrations. Some people do it differently. Me, I do commentary as well. Some people do things, I suppose, very straightforward. They know if they're going to make sound effects or try to attempt to do that or not. For me, well, I mean, as you heard, I kind of do it because there's not much else to read in the sort of combat heavy chapters, the fighting heavy chapters, which is one reason why I may very well adopt a new manga in this series, the sort of channel. It's just like I said, I was planning to read Uncle from Another World. There was another person who said, maybe I should read Tokyo Ghoul, because the manga is a lot different than the anime. And I'd seen the anime for Tokyo Ghoul. That was very similar to this one, as far as I remember. With the blood and other things. And other weird media implications that would be very interesting to talk about. But yes, I mean, for combat heavy chapters, oh my goodness, there's not much that I can do, because the sound effects, I have never really understood comic book sound effects. I remember, maybe some of you have seen the show Batman, like the old Batman show, where they used to sort of write it out. It was like, bam, he would punch someone and it would say bam, and it was, okay. I mean, maybe some of you have not seen that, but it was very, they basically tried to do the comic book sound effects in the show. It wasn't like the Batman series after that. I mean, it was sort of the one done with real people. It was a live action Batman a long time ago. Not that I lived during that time, but it's just that sometimes I watch some of those old shows. But, I mean, I forget, who did they have playing Batman? Was it Adam West? Someone like that. But, you know, they used to do the sound effects in the show. They used to have them written out. Specifically. But, as I said, maybe, I probably will be reading another manga in addition to this one, because maybe some of you have not seen my channel update video, which, people, I recommend you watch my channel update video if you want to know, sort of what I'm doing. Now, the gameplay in that video for the commentary does not have reshade in it because the reshade got messed up, unfortunately. I like to do commentary with reshade gameplay because reshade looks really pretty. And a lot of people, they like to see gameplay during commentary. Maybe some of you remember the old Leafy videos. Okay, but anyhow, besides the point, the channel update video has a lot of information in it pertaining to some of what I'm going to be doing in terms of what videos I may be releasing. As far as manga, it's just as I've said, I may read a manga with less combat in it, and then I probably will look at Tokyo Ghoul at some point. That was an interesting idea, but there are so many that I want to look at, and I, as far as me having much time to really complete all of them in a timely manner, I think Claymore is going to be the longest, so I'm not so worried about Claymore, because I will be reading Claymore every time, basically, I have the chance to do it. Basically, or if I feel like it. But, another one I was thinking about was Promised Neverland. I was planning to read Promised Neverland because that is a very interesting piece of media. There's all types of implications in Promised Neverland. I do not know why this video is messing up. Very sorry for that. Anyhow, well, I will see you, I was about to say I will see you in the next video. Let me say my usual, may you be blessed and farewell. People, okay.